more from the front lines of California's controversial family court system. We've been reporting on parents who say the court punishes them for even reporting child sexual abuse. Gina Silva's here with our series, Lost in the System. Gina.
Well, Laura, tonight we have the story of Deanne Salcido, a former family court judge who's speaking out. She admits to making a terrible mistake as a judge. She talks about that and also what really goes on behind the bench.
It's a jungle, it's a circus, and there's no ringmaster to speak of. It's a million-dollar industry at which the public, the average citizen's interest is lost.
Former Judge Deanne Salcido, now a whistleblower. She says family court is a circus, and so is the training in judges' school, especially for child abuse cases.
What I was trained on was to be suspicious of women who brought claims of abuse during a divorce matter. I was told that repeatedly in my first year as a judge, both in training at Monterey County for the new judges school. So not just me, but a whole classroom of new judges in family court.
So they were training you to be more suspicious of women.
They said be suspicious of the timing of abuse cases, which predominantly it was women. And their mentality was you have to make sure that they're not just trying to be bitter because the husband or the boyfriend has moved on or brought a new girlfriend into the scene.
How did that change you? How did that change how you ruled?
Well, I have to admit, I can think of one case in my first year that I made a mistake on, and that mistake continues to haunt me.
That case, Joyce Murphy's custody dispute. Murphy told Judge Salcido that her husband was sexually abusing their daughter. Salcido didn't buy it. She gave custody to the father, Henry Bud Parson.
I was following that be suspicious of the timing of abuse claims mantra that I was trained on.
Years later, Parson was convicted of molesting two preteen girls, his daughter's friends.
That hurts my heart right now talking about it. It's the thought of one child having to suffer another day, let alone for more years, and then another child was molested. But at the time I made that decision, I could not have been a judicial officer more than 6 to 9 months.